Hey, it's Justin again, Fully Live Athlete Pastor Channel. This is the Online Bible Reading Club, Day 22, and our text today is Exodus 4 through 6, chapters 4 through 6, and then we're going to be in Matthew chapter 14, verses 21 through 36. Now, the theme that we're going to look at today is that we all have to decide who we're going to trust, and that's what we call faith. We're going to have to live by faith in God or faith in ourselves. And you see Moses struggling with that in the first verses of chapter 4 of Exodus, where God has since last time revealed his personal name. You know, so he's addressed Moses and said, hey, take off your shoes, you're on holy ground, right? This is the Lord here. And he says to him, you know, I'm the God of your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He knows their names, which is astonishing, isn't it? Is it not? He personally knows Moses' fathers. Well, then when he gets to Moses meeting with God, what's fascinating here is God's revealed his personal name, Yahweh, Jehovah. The way it depends on how you want to say it. But every time in your Bibles, when you look down at this chapter and other places, you see the name Lord. It's all throughout the Bible, Lord, but it's in all caps, but smaller. That means behind that English word is the Hebrew name of the Lord, the covenant name, Yahweh. Very, very important, very special that God not only knows their names, but he shows them his name. And so you've got this idea of you're going to trust the one who is God and personal, or are you going to trust yourself? And he's going to make a case over and over that Moses should trust the Lord. So he's going to give him some signs, first of all, in order to impress Pharaoh that God is able to do what he says he is going to do, to set the people free. And if he doesn't, there's going to be very bad consequences. So he gives him this the staff, and the staff is going to turn into a serpent. He's going to catch it and put it back into being a staff. Terrifying, you know, it's a real snake, and it's going to be a terrifying sign. Then you've got the leprous hand. He's going to reach in his cloak and pull out his hand. It's going to be leprous. And then he's going to put it back. He's going to make it clean. You know, and it's going to be restored once he puts it back in. And so you're going to see these signs, these two signs, which are very, very important in redemptive history. You see the leper, you know, the quarantining that had to go on in Leviticus from those who had leprosy. And you see the snake is the enemy of God represented in Satan. And so he's picking him up by the tail and restoring him and operating, showing mastery over him and mastery over leprosy. He's making the people clean, the people that are unclean, clean. This is what God's doing. And so you think about that. Moses goes back to Egypt, and Pharaoh's going to flex and try to show off his power. He's going to make the people make bricks without straw, and he will refuse to let the people go. And so here's the thing. God's going to show over and over and over again that he will be faithful. He's going to bring the people out of slavery and deliver them into a land. He says, I will redeem you with an outstretched arm, and with great acts of judgment. I'll take you to be my people, and I will be your God. That's Exodus 6:7, and bring you out of the burdens. So, and then he's going to put you in the land which he swore to Abraham. Remember, this goes back to a covenant. Our lives and our redemption is resting upon a covenant, a promise that God make, a bond that he set upon a certain people that he chose. And we're a part of that people. We are children of Abraham by faith, as Galatians 3 tells us. So we all go back to the promise given to Abraham as our root of salvation. And that's fulfilled in Christ. Now you go over to the New Testament and you see that this is the famous passage. You've probably heard about this, even if you haven't read the Bible, that Jesus walked upon water. And why did he do that? Well, he's showing again mastery over creation, the ability to do exactly as he says will be done. And as you look at that, we've told you the theme today is faith. It's looking at the signs. It's evaluating, is God able to keep his promises or not? Or do I need to make my own way? Well, Peter walks out on the water at Christ's command, and then he starts to doubt, and then he starts to sink, and he says, well, you have little faith, Jesus says to him. Why did you doubt? That's this object lesson of that, hey, you know, you will walk through the waters. You will be set free. Where do we see that? We see that in Exodus, the exact same thing we just read. That's the big miracle that shows God sets his people free from sin and slavery and the devil, because he leads them through the Red Sea. But as the waters peel up above them and they pass by, he brings the sea down again to judge Pharaoh. You see that in the Jordan River, when the people pass back through the Jordan River to go to the Promised Land, that the waters are peeled up, and what could be a water of judgment? You think about the flood, the cataclysmic flood. God can use that same vessel of judgment for salvation for his people, and ultimately that's going to be the cross. The Roman execution of the cross is going to be for all the other criminals, judgment and complete and utter destruction. But for the believer who has faith in Christ, it is our very hope of salvation as we pass through the judgment of God unscathed. Remember back in Genesis 3, God put a flaming sword in the hands of an angel and says he will guard the way to the tree of life. Well, the only way we're getting in there is if our very Savior and Lord Jesus goes through that sword and is slain by it, and then rises again and brings us with him into the Promised Land to eat of the tree of life. And this is our hope. It's faith. Who will you trust? Will you trust yourself and your own works, or will you rely upon Jesus to be your Savior? This is the hope we have in Christ. So I hope that's helpful to you guys. Enjoy. Tomorrow is going to be the signs, that further signs to hit Pharaoh, and Moses is going to stand before Pharaoh and plead his case. So look forward to that. If you're listening all the way, go ahead and like the video and turn on the notifications and subscribe and do all the things. Leave some comments and questions if you got them. All right. Thank you. See you.